not ensure that your MP would live up to your expectations, would really stand up in the parliament in front of a prime minister who believes to be the second reincarnation of Adolf Hitler, you know, to ask him to address the question. So this you have to understand, because if the moment you fall in that trap, that's it. Forget about it. So, you know, be careful next time when you go out and vote and see what a government or a party is doing. Though it's open thing that we are supporting TRS. But this is very important for all of us as Indians to think over it.
But then there have also been allegations that in the a lot of money is required for an MP.
Yeah.
So how do you deal with that, and everyone, how do you make the voter aware of that?
So
I don't have
so
money coming out
so,
here.
So if you had asked me this question after today's 5 p.m. when the notification would be announced, I would have said no, we'll stick to the expenses which are given to us in MP. So I can still answer that question. Yes, it is true. You know, that is why there are many good people with a lot of talent and who wants to really do something are not able to win elections. Why? Because they don't have that financial wherewithal to withstand that whole election campaign of what, 15, 18 days. It's very difficult. So yes.
What is your strategy to be re-elected from Hyderabad Parliamentary constituency? What is it that you're going to be looking at?
Strategy is, you know, I know election is like a battle, and so you cannot go with a fixed strategy. You know, like okay, I'll do X, Y, Z. You have to re-strategize. You have to change your plan based on each and every day. Like for example, I remember in the last assembly elections, I was telling my party people, you know, don't immediately start attacking His Holiness Chandrababu Naidu and Rahul Gandhi. Wait for them to come and his Exhausted Highness Sri Narendra Modi and his company. Just wait. And they're telling me, no, we have to. I said, no, the time will come. So immediately when they, without our, we saying something, they started attacking us. I said, now go. So that was like, you know, so these are small things, but you have to be aware of when to attack, when not to attack. And sometimes you have to draw your opponent out. So we are trying to do now, we are trying to draw the siyasat owner out and contest against me. You know, so we're trying to draw him out, so please come out. Go over and come out. So these are things which we do, which every political party does. So part of the strategy is to win the Hyderabad seat, inshallah, with whatever little efforts or, you know, with people's duas and their cooperation, and also ensure that 16 parliament seats are won by TRS. Because I feel like the strategy is this, that once you have 17 parliament seats, the Telangana state will benefit. So this is an election wherein people of Telangana should really vote to ensure that the 17 seats which we get, we should be able to get more for Telangana. Because in the last 5 years, the Supreme Leader did not want to do much. The Supreme Leader had assumed that I have 280 seats, I will do as I want. So it is very important you have 17 seats of yours, and then you become a big factor once the government formation takes place.
But suppose if you still have the Supreme Leader only with whom you have to bargain then?
No, definitely the Supreme Leader this time around will not have Chetan. The Chetan are over. The Supreme Leader knows very well. So that is why yesterday Rajnath Singh said that we did three strikes, One I cannot tell you. So in response to that, I had tweeted that, sir, is it the third strike? Is it that when Modi went uninvited to Nawaz Sharif's house for marriage? So these are things which the supreme leader and his fascist group will definitely try. But the Achhe Din are not there anymore. The people in 2014, please remember this audience full of youth. The data tells us that in 2014, BJP got the highest number of youth vote. 31, I think so, they got 35-37% for CSG data I got. But anyway, they got the highest. So this time around, the youth are not going to be swayed by this, we did that. BJP, you should not allow BJP to hide behind their promises to you. They should not hide behind this narrative of nationalism, of we did that. That is what BJP wants to put forward, all these issues, so that they should not be probed and questioned by the people of India, in particular the youth. So this is a very important thing which one must know.
But what will be the role of TRS also? Because always it has been seen that if you have a chunk of people, then there is a lot of power brokering that happens, right? So there will be also outside support. What is it that there is no clear definition coming out from anywhere?
No, I can tell you for a fact that in the last assembly elections, KCR was very, very particular that BJP should lose everywhere. I can personally say that, because the numerous meetings I had with him, he was very particular. Asad bhai, come what may, BJP should not win even single seat. I want your assurance, I want your help, and we have to do it. The results can vouch for that, because out of 119 assembly segments that BJP contested, it is not the Congress party which defeated BJP in Telangana. More than 101 seats, they lost the deposits. They did win one assembly seat, but their party president lost. Ambarpet, and they lost Bhopal, and then Faridabad. So, these questions are all always raised. So, what would be the KCR stand vis-a-vis government formation? My answer to that is the proof is here in Telangana. And secondly, people who say that what will be, why don't they ask this question to Congress party? Are you going to cross 120 seats or not? I have said this before, let them cross 120 seats, the game is on. 150, you become the chowkidar. All chowkidars are sure in my opinion. But, you become. So that is also very important. See, there are two sides. It's not like, oh, so this, so see, regional parties are very much required for our polity, because India is a diverse country, and this diversity should also be represented in politics.
So suppose if they get 120, then what does TRS do? Do they join them? What do they do? What is the strategy then?
Then Telangana wins.
In what way?
It's a win-win situation for Andhra as a state and Telangana as a state. That will happen. What Mr. Naidu couldn't do, I'm sure Jagan will do it for Andhra Pradesh. Telangana as a state, a new state, had a great start. But I feel now if that happens, which you have just said, sky would be the limit for Telangana in terms of everything. And that is what will happen in Chhattisgarh.
Thank you so much. Okay, now I'm opening the house for the audience. Our first question is from Mariam. We now have Abdul Azim.
My name is Abdul Azim, and I'm an overseas citizen of India. question is, as an MP, would you rather consider yourself as efficient or effective?
So today our dates are out, that is, we have to decide. I would say both. But these are very strong terms, effective, efficient. You know, all of us as members of parliament or politicians, we try to be effective and efficient. But you see, you know, I don't want to sit here and boast about this and that. For me, every day I have to try and give my best, and it is not. I don't know how can I answer that, because it is for you to answer, you know. But definitely, this is a continuous process. I'm trying to be effective, efficient, work hard, you know, make sure my party lives up to the expectations of people. So this is an ongoing struggle. Some days you're good, some days you're not good. You're learning, you make mistakes. But as far as the intention is concerned, the intention is
okay, we have the next question from Abdul Mukit. Very good evening, sir. Let me start by wishing you all the very best for your political career in future, sir. My straightforward question to you is, I mean, how do you feel when represent a city which is a rainbow of different cultures, different societies, different people, different religions? My first question. And my second question for you for today is, sir, I mean, we see you on the TV screen, we see you off the TV screen, we see you in public meetings, we see you in cultural events, and we even see you hitting out some heavy weights in the gym. So I mean, how there is a lot more that can be asked in this question. How do you balance your personal and your political responsibilities in the current times?
So the first question of yours, it is indeed a great honor and privilege to be a member of parliament representing the great and historical city of Hyderabad. So I have no words to thank the people of Hyderabad, basically, because after having born over here, brought up over here, I have lived in this city, I have studied in this school, went to Nizam College, did all the things which everyone did, good or bad, you know, so This has been my life, you know. So I cannot take out Hyderabad out of me either, you know. So this is, I feel, this is a great privilege for me to be part of Hyderabad, to represent the people of Hyderabad, and it's also a huge responsibility in terms of what I do, in terms of so you know, when I say responsibility, I have to be careful as well, because people also judge he's from that city. How did he, what did he say, why did he say that? You know, there's always huge, people are always looking into things. So it's a great honor. It's a huge responsibility, which alhamdulillah, I'm trying to live up to it, to that expectation. Secondly, how do I balance my private life, personal life? I cannot complain, you know, alhamdulillah, Allah has been very kind to me, and when I hear politicians saying we don't have time for our personal life, that is load of dot dot dot. You know, you have time. It's not like, you know, I don't know why people make up that we don't have time, and then when someone says, oh, I didn't get married because I want to serve the people. But I'm living alone. You are a human being, you have to discharge that responsibility. You know, if I'm not good at home, what good can I be to you? You know, so this is a very important, point, you know, people don't realize that for a politician, if you are good at home, then you know that responsibility. So, I know, there's a lot of, I don't know why politicians try to behave in this way, not all of them, but many of them, who don't have time. You don't have time. What do you want? You know, if you are an MP, an MLA, I represent 20 lakh people. Out of 20 lakh people, people are electing me. Isn't that a great privilege? So to say that, oh, we don't have time, so don't enter politics. Don't complain, basically. You know, this is what it is. Because I remember when I was given a ticket in 1984, the first thing my party president, my late father, told me, I said, think over. And I was shocked. I said, what are you saying? You're not going to give me the ticket? He said, no, you think over. Because it's going to be from now, because I was very fresh from England, and you know, I had all those grandiose, whatever it is, those days, and you know, now it has gone. And he said, you will not have time for yourself, so you cannot complain. You cannot complain. You just cannot complain that I'm not getting this time and this and that. He said, you have seen my life, and your life would be, I don't know, it can get better or bad. So that's it. So we have this choice. We have used that choice. And then when you say, I don't have time, that is wrong to say, because we get time, you know. We get time to do all the things which a normal human being does. And we spend our time, good or bad, but I don't know, either, because I feel I'm really, truly blessed. And I cannot complain, because it would be really unthankful on my part to say that I don't have time for this or that. You know, my family is happy, everyone is happy, but good. You get time to do all the things, so it's not like, the reason I'm telling you is that you should join politics. Everyone does a job. Everyone has work to do. You know, someone does journalist over. She has a work to do. You know, she has a life. That doesn't mean she has no life. She has a life. I have a life. And so it's you can easily balance your personal and private life. There's nothing great about it.
Move to the next question. It's from Talat Madiha.
मोहन सिंह के बारे में हम बिल पेश किए थे, हमारे एक वकील दोस्त हैं, पसंद नहीं करेंगे उनका नाम भाई, वो उन्होंने उस बिल को ड्राफ्ट भी किया था, मगर मॉब लिंचिंग जो है वो अभी भी हमारे जो हमारे दस्तूर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के लिहाज से उसको पार्लियामेंट में एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया, क्योंकि वो अभी स्टेट सब्जेक्ट है और हमको मालूम था कि एक्सेप्ट नहीं होगा. मकसद ये था कि उसको डिबेट में लाए और डिबेट में आया अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह. जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने गवर्नमेंट से कहा कि आप इस पर कानून बनाइए, तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट अब हुकूम पर ऑर्डर पर अब शायद उस पर काम हो रहा है. अब रहा सवाल कि लोग देखिए, जमहूरियत है, कोई पसंद करेगा कोई नहीं पसंद करेगा. तो मैं तो कोई एक इस कंटेस्ट में नहीं हूँ कि हर लोग मुझे पसंद करें, और जो लोग मुझे पसंद नहीं करते मैं उनकी भी इज्जत करता हूँ, जब उनकी उस वक्त तक इज्जत करता हूँ जब तक वो मुझ पर पर्सनल अटैक नहीं करते. तो अल्लाह के दायरे में रहकर अगर आप ये मुखालफत करेंगे तो मैं भी अच्छा तैयार हूँ, और जब अल्लाह के दायरे से बाहर निकल जाते तो बाद वक्त हम भी चिचोरे हो जाते. रोकना पड़ता अपने आप को, क्योंकि मैं भी यही गली कूचों में बड़ा हुआ. हैदराबाद का चोरापन इसमें फिक्र की बात नहीं, जमहूरियत है तो ये सिलसिला चलता रहेगा, उस पर शुरू नहीं हुआ और उस पर खत्म होने वाला है, ये चलते रहेगा।
ओके, वी हैव इस्टार अहमद।
So this is my name is Iskandar Ahmed. I work as a project manager and I recently completed my job. I have a two-pronged question for you, the first part of which is that you have been batting for the formation of the third front alongside KCM. And that is because we need to give people an alternative from the province in politics of scenario than in the country right now, BJP on one hand and Congress on the other. So this political vacuum needs to be eradicated, and that is why you are important. But my question to you is, given the track record of coalitions in our country, how effective do you think coalition, if it comes to form, is going to be? And how, why do you think will it stand the test of time and parliamentary turbulence? The second part of my question is, Winston Churchill once said, democracy is the best and the worst form of government. Now, coalitions, a lot of people say, are the recipe for political anarchy and chaos. How do you assuage these concerns? How do you address that? And does two coalitions represent the worst side of a democracy?
So if you see the whenever coalition governments came into existence, things really happened for India. The foundations of real development took place. Whether it is the short-lived 96 experiment of Mr. Deshi Devagoda becoming the Prime Minister, and then Dural Sahab, and then we had the Janata Party. You remember that, I don't know whether you remember this or not, but I remember as a child. To get a passport in 1977, you had to get a sign of an MP on the form. So in 77, I remember my maternal grandmother Nani's house was in Malaysia, in Pratapadi Masjid. So right behind my Nani's house was the house of late Janab M.M. Hashim Sahab, who was the MP. And every day I used to see that from morning 6 o'clock there used to be a huge line of people, as if, you know, people going to a hospital. And I was later on, I asked my Babu, kya hai ye? Tumhare nahi nahi wo Hashim Sahab ke paas sign karane aa rahe passport. That Janata Party government, they said nothing doing to remove this condition. And you know what happened? The biggest beneficiaries are Muslims of Hyderabad. You know, then that boom was there, and in the Gulf countries, we don't require that signature of an MP, and you got a passport. So these are things which coalition government is there. They represent the diversity of India. Because whether it's Congress or BJP, there's not much difference, whether in terms of secularism or economic policies. That is where the regional parties would say, okay, this is an issue of my state. Jagan would say, Andhra Pradesh, we require this. KCR would say, you know, we wanted so many things to be done. The government of India has not given what is our rightful share. You know, for example, we wanted the bifurcation of High Court long time back, which would have had the lower judiciary of Telangana. It happened, this January. After what, 4 years? So to say that the coalition governments are instable, I don't believe, because 2004 to 2009, it was a Congress-led coalition, it was still a coalition. Many good things happened. Manrega, right to information, but then again, no coalition in 2009, you realize what happened. So, you know, you as an electorate, you must ensure that no one sits comfortably, whether it's me or anyone. You know, we should always perform. We should be on our toes. And otherwise, you know, BJP got 280. You know, they don't care. One fine day, the Supreme Leader says, no, I'll take off 500,000, you're gone. You know, can you imagine, and then he started laughing ke bachchi ki shaadi ke liye paise nahi hai. So these are things which are not good for the people of India. So that I feel, you know, coalition would be good for India, good for India's economic policy. It would be very good to address. Different states have different problems. Those problems can be addressed. So this is my answer to that question of yours.
We have Mohammed Zohair. The next question.
कुछ ऐसे न्यूज चैनल्स है जो हमेशा सिर्फ नफरत और ऐसे न्यूज चैनल्स है
एक मिनट का पहला सवाल भूल जाऊंगा दूसरे सवाल का पहला सवाल ये कि न्यूज चैनल का तो आपको मालूम आप मत देखिए आजकल तो पैसे मत दीजिए सब्सक्राइब बंद करिए बंद कर दीजिए अब तो आपके पास चॉइस है पहले ऐसा था कि आपको ला महाला मजबूरन देखना है तो अब तो जो जो मशहूर जर्नलिस्ट है रवीश शर्मा ने कहा कि जिस तरह देखना ही बंद कर दीजिए दो महीने तक मत देखिए आपकी तबीयत अच्छी हो जाएगी तो आप अखबार पढ़िए यू नो मैडम लिखते हैं न्यूज पढ़िए अच्छा लिखते हैं वो शायद कल तनकीद कर देंगे अपनी तारीफ की तो नहीं अखबार पढ़िए यू नो हम वैसे ही कह रहा हूँ आप लोगों से अखबार पढ़िए अखबार जरूरी है आपको न्यूज पेपर पढ़ना उसी में डिटेल है उसमें भी है लोग बट उसमें आपको मालूम हो जाता है क्या नहीं हो रहा आप आजकल तो न्यूज पोर्टल है बहुत से आप देखिए उनको जो जो आप जो चाहते हैं उस तरह की बात को रखते हैं तो ऐसा नहीं है कि हम मोहताज है टीवी के और तीसरी बात यह है कि टीवी देखना कम करिए आपका दिमाग अच्छा काम करेगा नहीं मैं आपको ऑनेस्टली कह रहा हूँ क्योंकि टीवी देखने से क्या होता है कि अगर आप मिसाल तौर पर रात में 10 बजे सोना है आपको 11 बजे सोना है आप टीवी देखिए आप 1.5 घंटे तक नींद नहीं आती आप उस दिमाग में ये चीजें चलना शुरू हो जाती तो टीवी कम देखिए पढ़ना ज्यादा करिए कश्मीर के लिए दुआ करिए कि अल्लाह वहां पर हमारे को कायम रखे और जाहिर है 4.5 साल में सरकार ने कुछ नहीं किया और इसी वजह से आज कश्मीर में तमाम मामलात हैं तमाम तकालीफ हैं और यकीनन वहां पर पैलेट गन के इस्तेमाल से इतने बच्चे नाबीना हुए हैं इतने नौजवानों की बीनाई जा चुकी है कमजोरी है आंखों के जख्म है और हुकूमत ही गवर्नेंस ही नहीं है इतना बड़ा वाकया हुआ पुलवामा का मगर कोई ये नहीं पूछ रहा हुकूमत से प्राइम मिनिस्टर से राजनाथ सिंह से कि इतनी बड़ी तादाद में वहां पर आर्टिस्ट गया कैसे कोई नहीं पूछ रहा ये इंटेलिजेंस फेलियर है तो कितने लोगों को आपने सस्पेंड किया अगर कोई और हुकूमत होती तो ये लोग तो बोलते कि क्या कर रहे हैं आप बिरयानी खिला रहे थे क्या बिरयानी खा रहे थे इस तरह का मगर अफसोस है कि जो बड़ी अपोजिशन पार्टी है वो भी इस पर बात नहीं करती उनको सिर्फ लगा है कि रफाइल की बात करो और ये भूल जाओ अरे भाई ये मसला है पूछिए ना कि कश्मीर में क्यों हुआ कश्मीर में ये वहां पर गवर्नेंस क्यों नहीं है कश्मीर में जो ताजिर है अगर वो लखनऊ में जाते हैं तो क्यों पीटा जाता है उनको तो ये सवालात है जो आप इन सवालात का जवाब अगर कोई सरकार नहीं देती है तो फिर आपको वोट डालने से पहले सोचना पड़ेगा सोच के वोट डालिए और अच्छा इस्तेमाल करिए
नॉर्थ इंडिया
उत्तर प्रदेश और बिहार के बात करें तो पूरे मुल्क में सबसे ज़्यादा नफरत की सियासत नहीं होती है और
नहीं कोई मजबूरी नहीं है जमहूरियत में कोई मजबूरी नहीं है क्योंकि उत्तर प्रदेश में 2007 में 2011 में 2017 में बड़ी मेजोरिटी के साथ गवर्नमेंट बनी तीनों मरतबा बिहार में भी आपके प्रदेश में इसी हुआ बाद में नीतीश और लालू का एलायंस सफर ये आवाम को फैसला करना पड़ेगा अगर आपने ऐसी सरकार के योग दिया जो नफरत की राजनीति कर रही है तो फिर आप उनके लिए दोबारा वोट मत दीजिए अगर आप बिहार में देख रहे हैं कि वहां पर शराब के कारोबार करने वाले बड़े दबाव हो चुके हैं तो इसके जिम्मेदार कौन है आपने शराब को तो बैन कर दी नीतीश राजा ने मगर वो शराब का कारोबार फूट लेकर हर जगह ताकतवर हो चुके हैं सीमांचल में अगर डेवलपमेंट नहीं है इसका जिम्मेदार कौन है आपको फैसला लेना पड़ेगा सीमांचल के इंसाफ के लिए अगर आप एक अच्छे आदमी को एमपी बनाएंगे तो ना सिर्फ सीमांचल बल्कि बिहार के गरीब आवाम की आवाज उठाएगा इसलिए देखिए आप उसे सवाल कर रहे हैं मैं आपका शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ मगर आपको सोचना पड़ेगा आवाम को वोटर्स को सोचना पड़ेगा क्योंकि अगर आप ये उम्मीद लगा के बैठेंगे कि क्या हिंदी कहावत है कि क्या बोलते पेड़ा बबूल का निकला क्या वजह तो आप ऐसा नहीं कर सकते ये आपको फैसला करना है कि आप किसको वोट दे रहे हैं आप बाशऊर हैं अगर आप किसी बेकार किस्म के पार्टी का साथ दे रहे हैं तो फिर आपको आप उम्मीद मत रखिए कि आपको अच्छा नतीजा निकलने वाला है तो इसलिए ये आपको सोच समझ कर अपने वोट का इस्तेमाल करना पड़ेगा
We move to the next question. Alishan Saha.
Speak to the police, women's wing, we use our sphere of influence in making them understand that what is good and what is bad. But definitely I agree that we have to do more, and inshallah we'll try to do more in coming months and in coming years.
We have the next question from Tanis Fatima.
I have a question as the starting is only for a learning project. I have a question on learning only. And like me being not highly qualified, but still I'm a mother of two kids. And I have a difficulty of giving education, proper education. Proper education to my two kids, as I'm a single mother. So I need to know, like, is there any facilities where I can get, personally, not personally, I could say for a single woman, where we can get our children educated well. Because since many years I've had this difficulty, wherein I couldn't get any help from anybody. Though I tried to take help from trust, but still I'm helpless.
So this is related to your children's education or your personal
It's about education.
So my request to you would be that the Telangana government with my party has played a little bit role in that, in establishing the residential schools. Please, I mean from class 6 onwards, if your children are that old, please try to put them in those residential schools. Because this will really benefit them. And these are very good schools. In these schools, the government is spending a lakh of rupees every year on each student. And this itself was not there 5 years ago. So I don't know where you live, but I'm sure that in the surrounding area or in the adjacent area, these residential schools are there. And if you want my help in getting your children, if they can get put in class 6, I'll definitely help you so that your children can get to the school. There is a much, much, much better side to my younger brother Akbar, which unfortunately nobody wants to see. But he's running these schools, and wherein in those schools nearly 8,500 poor families' children are studying free of cost. And I don't know where you live, I don't want to know, so we will help you in that. And thirdly, please, whenever after elections, please come to Darussalam and then we'll see what we can do. Because this is very important. I understand being a single mother, it's not easy in this world. And especially, unfortunately, people don't realize that people talk about a single mother, don't worry about it. These are some things are not in our control. I feel whatever happens, alhamdulillah, it happens for good. But your concern is very, very important, and I wish that everyone, every mother has this concern about the future of their children. Inshallah, we are there for you. Please let us know what help we can be. But we'll definitely, if we cannot do anything, you be rest assured, we are with you.
Thank you.
The
next question is from Hussein Machliwala.
What is the future of the Muslims in the politics of India, and what are the party's plans for that?
The future of Muslims in Indian politics is future of Muslim Indian politics is IP. And the responsibility lies with us also as a community. Why? Because we have been programmed and brainwashed from 1950 onwards to up to 2018. And if you don't change, that will continue in eternity. And we have been programmed that you have to save secularism. So my request is that, whoever has done this brainwash, please detoxify yourself and take this stupidity out of your mind that we are not here to do everyone's work. Saving of secularism is a responsibility which each and everyone shares. But we believe that no, we have to do more. So now today dates have been announced. You go and read every Urdu newspaper online, you will definitely find at least 5 statements telling the Muslims, ab qaum aur millat ko jamhooriyat ko bachana hai, secularism ko bachana hai. अपने वोट का सही इस्तेमाल करिए भाई. हम लोग तो 16 पार्लियामेंट के इलेक्शन हो चुके हैं, भी बचा रहे क्या? तो आप बचे, आज अपने आप को पहले बचाइए आप. और जब आप अपने आप को बचाएंगे, सेक्युलरिज्म बचेगा. तो ये जो है ना, सियासत में शहादत का कोई कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है, याद रखिए. सियासत में कोई मार्टिरडम का कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है. सियासत में जिंदा रहना है. आप जिंदा रहेंगे तो गुनाह भी करेंगे, सवाब भी कमाएंगे. आप मर जाएंगे, कोई ना सवाब मिलेगा ना. आप जिंदा रहेंगे तो लोग आपके पास आएंगे. आप मर गए तो फिर शायद आपके घर वाले आपको तस्वीर के बाद थोड़ा फूल चढ़ाएंगे, फातिहा देंगे, अगर फातिहा देने वाले हैं तो उसके बाद भूल जाएंगे. या फिर साल के एक मरतबा बेचारे कोई रोके दुआ करेंगे, अरे भाई ये नहीं हो सकता. तो पहले अपने आप को बचाइए. और कैसे बचाएंगे आप अपने आप में तब्दीली पैदा करिए. अपने दिलो दिमाग से इस खौफ को निकालिए कि मैं मर जाऊंगा. भाई मरना एक ही बार है, दो बार नहीं है. एक खुद एतमादी पैदा करिए अपने आप में, एक कॉन्फिडेंस पैदा करिए कि हाँ मैं हालात का मुकाबला कर रहा हूं. आप कर रहे हालात का मुकाबला. देखिए जो हमारी मुसलमानों की जो पिछले 60 साल की जर्नी रही है, इसमें ईमानदारी से मैं कह रहा हूं कि इसमें इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट्स का कोई रोल नहीं रहा हमारे डेवलपमेंट के लिए. तो जितना भी आप और हमने हासिल किया वो हमारे माँ बाप की मेहनतों की वजह से, उनकी दुआओं की वजह से. कोई गवर्नमेंट आकर हमको, और माशाल्लाह से आप देखेंगे कि हिंदुस्तान में जितने लोग 10,00,000 करोड़ या 500 करोड़ लोन देना बाकी है बैंक्स का, उसमें एक भी मुसलमान नहीं है. ना पूछो कि नीरव मोदी की तरह 10,000 पाउंड का जैकेट पहन के फिर रहा ऑस्ट्रिच स्किन का. सो ये रियलाइज करिए, इस डर को निकालिए. डरने की जरूरत नहीं है, ये हमारी जमहूरियत है, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन जिंदा है. जब आप इसको पहली चीज निकाल देंगे अपने दिमाग से, जो हमको प्रोग्राम कर दिए. देखिए आप और हम जब इस दुनिया में आए तो हमारे अब्बा ने, हमारे बुजुर्गों ने, या हमारी माँ ने, या फिर कोई मुत्तकी शख्स ने आकर कान में अजान. तो दूसरे कान में क्या बोलती है, बेटा सेकुलरिज्म जिंदा रखना. भूलिए, डरने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. मैं याद रखी मेरी बात को, आप नहीं मालूम जिंदगी कब तक वफा करेगी मेरे साथ, मगर जब तक आप इस दिमाग से इन चीजों को नहीं निकालेंगे, आप यही सवाल 20 साल के बाद भी करेंगे. आप ये पहले निकालिए, उसके बाद देखिए कि रास्ता खुद बनेगा. और हमारे मुल्क में बहुत से हमारे गैर मुस्लिम भाई बहन हैं जो हमारे साथ ठहरने के लिए तैयार हैं, मगर हम इस बात को नहीं समझना चाह रहे. हम क्या समझते हैं कि नहीं मुसलमान मुसलमान सही है, मगर दलित भाई हमारे, हमारे ट्राइबल भाई हैं. आज भी हमारे मुल्क में ऐसे हिंदू भाई हैं जो हमारे लिए मर मिटने के लिए तैयार है. वो फुला पार्टी है, कोई पार्टी ऐसी नहीं है, ये सिर्फ अपनी पार्टी कर रहे हैं. तो आप इसको चेंज लाइए भाई, प्लीज. डर निकालिए, खौफ को दूर करिए, इत्मीनान पैदा करिए, यकीन करिए जमहूरियत पर, और बार बार बोलते देखो जिंदा रहना है तो इनको और दो, उसके बाद लोग मरना ये नहीं हो सकता ना, ये बहुत जरूरी है। इलेक्शन आया कि लोगों कुमार को जिंदा रहना है तो आपको खुदा तारीफ के दिन अपनी जिंदा कौम का सबूत देना, उसके बाद रोज मरना नहीं हो सकता, ये नहीं हो सकता भाई, इसको तब्दीली लाना पड़ेगा। और आप जैसे जनरेशन से मेरी उम्मीद है कि आप लोग वो चेंज लेकर आएंगे, आप लोग आप लोग बढ़कर अपने अपने का फैसला आपको तय करना है। अगर आप छोड़ के बैठे रहेंगे कि नहीं भाई वो खुदा शख्स तय करेगा, नहीं हो सकता मेरे भाई, आप में काबिलियत है, आप खुद अपने डेस्टिनी का फैसला ले सकते हैं, आप खुद तय कर सकते हैं कि मैं किस रास्ते पर जाऊंगा। ये हमको रियलाइज करना है, और यकीनन हमको हमारे गैर मुस्लिम सेकुलर दोस्त भाई बहन को साथ लेके करेंगे, और वो तैयार है मैं कह रहा हूँ, मगर हमारे मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी हमको क्या है, अरे यहाँ उन्हें साथ देता नहीं देता भाई साहब, आप 50 साल से इन चोरों का साथ, एक मरतबा इंसानों का साथ,
we now have S.A. Arafa. Arafa.
Salaam alaikum. Sir, myself, I'm Arafa. I'm a UPSC aspirant. Sir, my question to you is that you often talk about inclusive development for the lower strata of the society. So, why don't you start civil service coaching institution similarly on the lines of Learn Project, so that many youth can join bureaucracy and formulate inclusive policy. And there are only 2.5% Muslim IAS officers as per the Rajinder Sachar Committee report of 2005, which was later approved by Professor Amitabh Kundu Committee of 2010. Thank you, sir.
I cannot give a very yes, unanswered yes or no that we'll start or we cannot start, because you must be knowing that this is a very, it's not an easy thing to establish a coaching center for civil service aspirants. Lot of planning, lot of work has to be done. Let us see what happens, because we'll have to really apply our minds and see what we can do. There is a center which is there in Nizam College, some state government does it. There's also one center in Manu. And there's a center in Jamilia as well. So let us see what, I don't know, I'll really have to go back and meet my party people and see what we can do.
We have a next question from
Rifa
Fazilat.
Sir, as I said earlier, this initiative is more for your advantage to learn. So, like, it's been already a month, so what change can we expect further with respect to this initiative?
I think so. Muzamil should answer this question.
What have you learned?
This has been a good learning experience. You see, as politicians, we are used to वाह 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 क्या 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 तो उसे दिल भी रहेगा कि क्या गलत काम करे, और फिर भी disposed to say हाँ साहब बिल्कुल अच्छा बहुत
अच्छा. So how do you find this audience? This more interactive?
No, not the audience, but the two sessions which I attended in a Chaar Minar and the questions which I faced, which were asked. You know, these are very humbling experiences wherein a politician is brought down to nature, Mother Earth, these are the concerns. Because sometimes we get so carried away by accolades and these praises that we forget that there are some real issues which we have completely ignored. So this has been a good learning experience, especially, mashallah, so many youth have been participating to hear their concerns, their issues, would definitely, you know, would make us change, would make us adopt those issues and address them. So, you know, how to continue it? Yeah, hopefully we should continue it. I'll see what, you know, how best we can take it forward. And I hope that it should not be limited to one parliament or assembly election, so that we can have a continuous strategy wherein we keep on going back and meeting people through this Learn project, so that we bring in a change in the society, and we address those issues, because Hyderabad or Telangana is a very diverse area and there are different issues, and unfortunately we politicians are very fixated on 3-4 things that we do this between elections. You know, that should not be the case. So we'll see what we can do.
Another question is, like, as the government says, it is for us, with us and by us. So, like, it should be, like, dependent on people, like, are we even listening? Because the government and the citizen, we are not even proportionate, right? So what is your approach to this context?
Well, you have to just, please say again, I missed something over there, please.
Exactly. Actually, as the government says, it is for the people, by the people, with the people. But we usually see there is no proportionate between the government and the citizens. So what is your approach?
My approach is, by sitting in our office, Darul Salaam, and meeting people 6 days a week, that in itself is a huge, it's a great experience. It makes us understand what is the pulse of the people, what are people looking at, how people issues can be addressed properly, what are their immediate requirements. You know, that is what it is, and I'll share you something that a very important TRS functionary met me 10-15 years ago and said, "Mr. Bhai, you want to come and sit in Darul Salaam and see this Darul Salaam 6 days a week when people come and sit, how it helps you, and we want to incorporate that as well." You know, that is a great thing. So I realized that, but I must say that this working president of TRS is a very perceptive man. So this is what it is. You know, so when you say by the people, for the people, is I cannot just win an election and go away. You know, I have to be in constant touch with the masses, with the electorate, and listen to what they have to say, address those issues. So we as elected representative must be in constantly touch with people, and that can only happen if you're accessible. And once you're accessible, then by the people, for the people, whatever it is, you know, we can really address those issues and problems.
We have the next question from Anjali.
Good evening, sir. Sir, why the Swachh Bharat is not totally implemented in the whole city? The people, they have dumped the garbage directly into the roads while we are walking on the roads. And why it is very important to clean the area, but the municipal people are not cleaning the area directly. Why it is like that?
I agree with you that as far as sanitation is concerned in the city, a lot needs to be done. And I would hesitate to say that we have to do more, we have not been able to do more. We have been constantly representing to the GHMC that please increase the sanitation staff, there are a lot of vacancies over there. And we have to do more, to be honest with you, we'll definitely have to do more, and I'll remember this question of yours, this advice of yours. We'll try our utmost best to ensure that sanitation is done in a proper way, and garbage lifting is done properly. And we should have more of those autos in the whole city, so that they come and pick up all those rubbish or garbage which is there. But I agree with you, more needs to be done, and we'll definitely try to do more.
It's also more about the behavior change.
No, I don't want to, I don't want to say that thing, because, it's not good for us to say because people will feel bad about it. अरे मैं क्या मारे में आप क्या कर रहे हैं? So what I can do, I say yes, I do. I have not done. So these are very.
Yeah, but if you put it this way, you know, saying that old city is white city, so you should be more responsible.
It is very easy for me to sit here and say, "Hey, aap me change laiye, bula kariye." It doesn't happen like that, you know. I should do my work, and then what is my work? I do. You do your work, and then I cannot sit here and say, "Hey, aap me wo nahi hai." It's not. You know, I've been hearing this nonsense for last 20 years. It is my work. Let me do my work, and I cannot expect if I have a garbage bin, or if I provide an auto, if I provide a rickshaw, definitely he goes there, and that person would not have arisen if more trips were made in a day to collect the garbage from that area. So you know, these are things which we have to do, and we definitely do. This is a weakness of ours, and we have to do more.
The next question is from Ashfaq Ali Khan.
Assalamu alaikum. Just right now, previously a question was asked about sanitization.
About sanitization.
My question is about the dumping that's being done next to the Shivaji Bridge, which is located right outside the Jalandhar Museum, where tourists come to see. And this dump is inviting mosquitoes and other parasites, which are responsible for causing infectious diseases such as dengue fever and malaria, and is affecting the health and hygiene of the residents living around it. It has become a massive source of pollution, filling the air with toxic odors and polluting the groundwater. This dump has several large and small dumping yards which have moved into the Kusamiji, which was once a beautiful flowing river in our city's inheritance from the Shah dynasty. This is my humble request to you, sir, to please visit this site and solve this issue and move this dump out of the city so the health of the citizens is not compromised. And we as youth, what can we do to solve this situation? Thank you very much.
You don't need to do much. I have to go. You have done so much by reminding me of my duties. I accept it's a huge problem. I accept it's an issue. We were successful as a party in removing a garbage dump from Golconda, and now we have that golf course over there. So we definitely try our utmost best to ensure that. Area is not utilized or dumping, and do something about it. But I cannot give you a time frame, but we definitely try to ensure that those issues, which we are facing, health issues, pollution, that can be addressed properly.
The next question is from Mr. Bhaktia. Okay. Yeah, I'll give a chance, definitely. There's a list here. That's
good.
Yeah.
So we'll have to finish by 6:25.
Yeah.
Right? For that.
Mr. Akram. Okay. Thami Shahid.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. Sir, we've seen over the 5 years that the BJP has been in power that there's a big difference between the campaign for Narendra Modi and the PM for Narendra Modi. That PM Narendra Modi doesn't take any live questions. He doesn't address the youth that the way that you are doing today, sir. The way that the PM addresses the media is that he has scripted questions. If I can use a millennial Twitter talk hashtag, chaliye gulcheri ko vanakam. So as you are a recipient of the Sansad Ratna Award and you are very well versed with the parliamentary proceedings, sir, you know that the ministers are not required to sign the attendance register in the parliament. At least to bring more accountability on the floor of the house, should we bring a law or bring a parliamentary procedure that requires all of the council ministers, at least the cabinet, to sign the attendance register, compulsory participation, and make the Prime Minister more answerable on the floor of the ground so that he can answer questions directly that the people can ask, especially regarding demonetization and GST, which have made massive failures. Thank you, sir.
As far as the attendance register of ministers is concerned, you see, a minister has numerous responsibilities. But the ideal practice is that when parliament is in session, all of them should be present over there. Which I feel that they're always, normally they're always present, unless until some foreign dignitary is coming. But I am of the opinion that we should really, when we have followed this stupid system of first past the post system, why can't we follow the system of British Parliament, wherein an MP can stand up and ask any question to the Prime Minister? They have a question time for the Parliament, for the Prime Minister's question time. Normally it's Wednesday or Thursday. Please watch it. It's not watching all good and bad things on TV. This would really help you. That any MP, without giving even the notice that I'm going to ask on better city modernization, you can just stand up. With the Speaker's permission, we ask the Prime Minister that particular question. I think so. We should bring that change. And I think so. Last 5 years, maybe someone should do a research and tell that. I don't think so. The Prime Minister answered any question, because I don't think so. At least Manmohan Singh had answered some few questions. He comes the way he walks in Parliament is like. When I was young, we used to watch on TV Vivian Richards going to bat and just going to murder all bowlers, 6 and 4. So when he walks in, everyone stands up, and then that darn boy, then all the starts. But he hasn't answered, you're right. The Prime Minister should answer. The Prime Minister should not only give speeches on important debates like President Address or on important bills, but we must change our parliamentary rules, wherein if we cannot adopt the British system, let us at least have that, okay, in one parliament session, the Prime Minister should answer some questions, maybe 5 times, 4 times. That would be a very good thing, so that the people know that our democracy is transparent, functioning, working. Definitely the ministers also are there, but you're right, the Prime Minister should also answer to questions during the question time in the parliament session.
We'll take 4 more questions, 2 from boys, 2 from girls. So I have just 4, so please.
My question is that पॉलिटिक्स में आना आपका इरादा था या आपके फादर आए तो मैं आऊं?
कोई भी पॉलिटिशियन आवाम का काम करके एहसान नहीं करता। हमारी जिम्मेदारी है, हम उसकी जिम्मेदारी निभा रहे हैं। अगर हम लोग ये समझेगा मैं बहुत बड़ा एहसान कर रहा हूँ तो आप निकाल के फेंक देना उनको, लिटरली एहसान करने कोई नहीं बैठे। ठीक है, आपको अगर आप मेरे वोट डाल रहे हैं तो आप बहुत बड़ा मुझ पर एहसान कर रहे हैं, मैं कोई एहसान नहीं कर रहा हूँ। तो इसलिए आपसे मेरी गुजारिश है कि आप शायद क्या है भाई 11 अप्रैल को पोलिंग है, तो आप निकल के एहसान करिए हम लोगों को, एहसान करिए भाई, आप निकलना है आप लोगों को, आपको निकल कर हैदराबाद में अगर खाली 48-49% पोलिंग होगा तो आप निकलिए, निकल के हम पे एहसान करिए, 70-80% पोलिंग करिए, ताकि हम आपके एहसान के तले हमेशा दबे भी रहेंगे और काम करते रहेंगे।
So they have to the penalty of all that. So it's a main concern which I am voting for a lot of parliamentarians, but I could not get the opportunity. So I request you to please look into this ordinance, company's ordinance 2019. So then central government says they want to bring FDL, but this is lot of penalties to Indian companies is one of major concern. Second question, sir, as per the minority budget of Telangana, which recently spent, only 35% is being spent. And this is the report as per the Hindu, which was introduced by Sayyid Muhammad of the Hindu. So I request Arnav Akbarovic is ready to go back to the assembly. I request you to please put this point that why only 35% of the budget is being spent on minorities.
I repeat. 2018-19 का बी था 1973 करोड़, हमारे पास जो है वो रिलीज हुआ 1417 करोड़ और एक्सपेंडिचर हुआ उसमें से 819 करोड़। वैसे ही 2017-18 का बी था 1226 करोड़ और रिलीज हुआ 1124.25 करोड़ और उसमें से एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर हुआ 942.67 करोड़। अगर आप 2016-17 में जाएंगे तो बी था 1200 करोड़ और रिलीज हुआ 1100 करोड़, इसमें से एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर हुआ 863.36 करोड़। तो मेरे ख्याल से ये जो प्रॉब्लम है, जो रिलीज तो हो रहा एक्सपेंडिचर कम हो रहा, तो इसकी वजह यह है कि माइनॉरिटीज डिपार्टमेंट में और ऑफिशियल्स का तफरुक अगर होगा तो हम सही तरीके से पूरे बजट को इस्तेमाल कर सकें। तो जब आप एक्सपेंडिचर होगा तो गवर्नमेंट और देगी, तो ये एक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव प्रॉब्लम है और इंशाल्लाह हम गवर्नमेंट से नुमाइंदगी कर रहे हैं। आप जैसा कि अब थोड़े दिन दो दिन तीन दिन पहले गवर्नमेंट जो है 40 करोड़ रुपये रिलीज करेगी, जिसमें कई बच्चों के ओवरसीज स्कॉलरशिप के पैसे रुके हुए थे, इमामों के ऑनरेरियम रुका हुआ था, ये दो चीजें काम हो रहा है। हदीसुल गुरबा के 20 करोड़ की लागत से काम चल रहा है वो भी। तो और पहला सवाल के ताल्लुक से आपको मेरे को गाइड करना पड़ेगा, मैं एक्सपर्ट नहीं हूँ, आप मेरे को समझाइए, मेरे को गाइड करिए, यकीन है मैं आपका इस तरफ का पूरा दावा दे रही हूँ।
I don't know what will happen. I don't know. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Mohammad Salman. I am from Old City.
मैं आपसे वादा कर रहा हूँ आपके ताबूत से आपके दुआओं से अगर मैं कामयाब होगा तो फलकनुमा में जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की कमी है मैं अपने एपी फंड से वहाँ पर ऑलरेडी बिल्डिंग बन रही मेरे एपी फंड से डिग्री कॉलेज की बिल्डिंग बनाएंगे और उसमें बिल्डिंग में कंस्ट्रक्शन और टॉयलेट भी शामिल रखेंगे और लेबोरेटरीज भी रखेंगे। ये अगर हम दो तीन काम कर लेंगे तो सारा फिर स्टाफ व आपकी जो जरूरत है वो गवर्नमेंट से बोल के करवाएंगे। ये मैं कर सकता हूँ, गवर्नमेंट तो बाद में आएगी, पहले मैं अपने अपनी फंड से जो मैं बारकस में वादा कर रहा हूँ कि बारकस में भी वहाँ पर खवातीन के लिए जूनियर डिग्री कॉलेज बनाएंगे इंशाल्लाह। फलकनुमा में मैं फंड दिया हूँ, मेरा मैं जरूर इस्तेमाल करूंगा। और मेरी आपसे गुजारिश है कि 23 मिनट काउंटिंग हो जाएगी, अगर मैं कामयाब हो गया तो आप जो है जून जुलाई में आ जाइए इंशाल्लाह, इसको अपन टेकअप करेंगे और आप मैं करूंगा
You are my inspiration, first of all, for Tibet, how the way you sit like a Rajnikant in the calm way. And my question is that, sir, as we all know, we have the right to speak to the government what is going on. So, sir, asking about how many people were died in that strike, asking that thing that kitne log mare, kitne logon ko aapne mara hai, that is a right thing or a wrong thing? And second thing is that I am a mass media student, what is the future for me in upcoming, in future, in India?
So, thank you for making me Rajnikant. I was expecting that you would call me Gopal Singh. Or something worse. But anyway, thank you. So now, you're a mass speaker, you have a huge opportunity. And in terms of if you want to be very, if you want to really live up to the great expectations of journalism, it will not be an easy journey for you. If you want instant gratification, you start supporting the government, usually somewhere else. So if that happens when you sell your soul. So my only request is that you should be a brave journalist. You should be able to criticize a Saudi Novisi, a Saudi Novisi does mistakes or wrong things. My affection for you is a different thing, but by criticizing me, you will be correcting me. And ensuring that you can check me as well. So that is what every aspiring mass journalist should do. You should not succumb to the pressures of the government and do your work. But you must, my request to you is that you must read more. Read more books.
Yeah.
Spend more time on books other than on TV. The more you read non-fiction books of great people, keep yourself abreast, because what I feel is that there are many journalists who join, but for example, if you like business, then read all those things, get to know what is happening, or security, or urban development. That you gain experience and use RTI more. That would be good.
We'll wind up the session then. Thank you very much, everybody. Thanks for being here.